All right. LDBC, it is your boy Coach Shelton Harrison. You're live on the Coach Shelton Harrison Combat Sports Show Live. Okay, guys, I'm going to go in, and I pretty much told y'all about Mackenzie Dern, okay? Now, you know, ain't nobody hating on Mackenzie Dern. Either you like Mackenzie Dern or you don't like her. Right now, I'm kind of on the fence. It's a lot of stuff I just don't like about her. You know, I just don't. You know, number one, you know, they really hyping this girl up. They hyping up so bad that Mackenzie Dern, she's starting to believe her own hype. Like she really is. Because, you know, she running around here saying that, you know, she beat up Amanda Bobby. I mean, I'm sorry, she beat up Ashley Yoder, and that Amanda Bobby Cooper is going to be easy work compared to her. So, you know, I'm like, oh, so you're going to have an easier time against Amanda Bobby Cooper than Ashley Yoder. Okay. So, you know, I guess Mackenzie Dern forgot the fact that Ashley Yoder beat the heck out of her. I mean, beat her down. Okay. Mackenzie Dern forgot that she took an ass whooping. I think she did forget. And matter of fact, not only did she forget, you know, she was given a gift decision. Mackenzie Dern lost the fight. Okay? She lost to Ashley Yoder. Ashley Yoder defeated Mackenzie Dern. See, it's one thing. It's one thing to understand that, okay, you got respect for your opponent, and you know. And, you know, and I understand, ABC started the trash talk. And, you know, Mackenzie Dern responded. So I get it. The trash talking is not an issue, but the fact that you had to include Ashley Yoder in that. Okay, you didn't beat Ashley Yoder easily. What is she thinking? And you're not going to beat Amanda Bobby Cooper easier. It's not going to be easy work. This girl finna get exposed. I'm telling y'all, this girl, her mind not focused on MMA. This girl, you know what she do, man? You know, when a head coach tell you that you got to leave, like they're telling you to leave. If a coach tell you to leave the team, there's something going on. And I don't want to hear this, oh, where she was splitting time between Arizona. There's a personality conflict. You can say what you want, okay? There's a personality conflict that also digs in that, and also the level of commitment, the true level of commitment. You know, the MMA lab, you know, MMA lab, they don't want no sloppy fight on that. They don't want no uncommitted fighter, and then she go in there and get knocked out, and then so she can run around and say, oh, well, it's the MMA lab that did it when the girl ain't committed. If I'm a coach, I don't take athletes like that they have committed, and then, you know, they want to. I used to do that decades ago. Like, when I've been coaching since I was a teenager. You know, like about 10, 12 years ago, I used to do that. And I would honestly work with people, and then, you know, they would come here and there, then they have a bad performance, and you know what they were doing? They was going back saying, well, it's Coach Shelton Harrison's fault that, you know, we didn't do that well. But, you know, all along, these people not committed. So I stopped working with people who can't train with me no more than 5 days a week, because if they work with me five or less days a week, then I know that I can guarantee them results. But if they work with me 1 day here, 2 days here, I can't guarantee that, and then that gives them a scapegoat, you know, for why they're underachieving and for why they're losing. Yeah. See, I peaked game on that. I peaked game on that, you know, real early. I mean, it took me a while to get it, but when I finally figured that out, I can't train with these folks, man. I can't train because these people, they're going to give me a bad name. They're going to mess up my business. Okay? These people, they're going to do all of that because they don't have any dedication. And Mackenzie Dern, to me, is one of those people, okay? She don't have the dedication she need for MMA. I'm telling you, this girl gonna get slept. Somebody gonna knock this girl out, and I'm telling you, she gonna move up in the rankings, and she gonna get to an opponent that's stable enough, and they gonna beat her down. This girl not serious about MMA. This girl spent all her time. I found this photograph right here. This is the first photograph I found of her. Well, you know, half of her crack, the crack of her behind not showing, or you know, her cleavage ain't showing, or you know, mostly all of her breasts, you know, not showing. This is one of the only photographs that I found. And then she did the interview, and I'm surprised she had clothes on. I'm shocked Mackenzie Dern had clothes on when she did an interview with Kenny Florian and Michael Bisping. I mean, good grief, man. So this woman is not dedicated as much as she need to be. And the MMA labs, they picked up on that. They were like, yo, this girl ain't dedicated. She gonna go in here and get knocked out. The MMA labs, they not stupid, man. They know the girl was getting pieced up by Ashley Yoder. They know she was. And anybody who say, you know, Ashley Yoder, you don't know nothing about fighting. Ashley Yoder won that fight very decisively, man. Look, Mackenzie Dern got a gift. This hype job got a gift, and that's what she is, hype job. Mackenzie Dern gonna have to show me, man. She can't get no gift decision. There can't be no controversial wins. Mackenzie Dern, for me to get on board, she's gonna have to beat some quality opponents. I'm talking about beat them and beat them decisively, or beat them to the point where there isn't a controversy, okay? That's not an issue with the judging. No controversy. She gotta do it decisively, then I get on board, but right now, Mackenzie Dern, nah. She ain't got no discipline. And early in her career, you know, this girl couldn't even make weight, man. This girl couldn't even make the strawweight limit. You know, a few times she missed weight. And usually when you have a person miss, now you miss weight one time, you know, things happen. But if you're missing weight multiple times and you've done that, that shows a lack of discipline somewhere, and that lack of discipline will rear its ugly head once again. I'm telling y'all it will. That lack of discipline by this girl will begin to rear its ugly head, and you'll see. And I think the MMA lab, they picked up on. I've been a coach for years. When a head coach asks you, you know, they tell you to leave, they don't want to train you no more, there's a huge commitment level that's not there, and that's also a personality conflict. I know this. I've been coaching for over 2 decades. And I know that you just don't ask a person to leave just because you want to ask them to leave. I'm telling you, man. Guarantee this girl, I bet she talked, and she's an exhibitionist. You get people who exhibitionists, like they can't stop taking photographs of themselves. They can't stop showing, you know, they behind. They can't. You know what? These people, they're not focused people. I mean, look at the people you see on Instagram. Them some of the most unfocused and unmotivated people that you know. They ain't doing nothing for themselves but taking photographs of they behind. And I'm sitting here thinking to myself, you know, they spend, you know, there's people that have like, they put up like, what, 30 photographs in a day. And it's like, is there that much time in the world to keep taking these photographs? I mean, aren't you supposed to be trying to do something productive? You know, that's what I'm thinking with some of these people, these Instagram people. I mean, is Instagram paying you money to put photos up there? I mean, folks, come on. I had an Instagram account. I'm not on. I'm too busy. You know, and I do my YouTube because it's productive, and I use it because in the end, it is going to benefit me. I'm doing something with YouTube. Okay, but you know, I have my gym, you know, I'm with my students. I do a lot of different things, okay? So I don't have the time to be on social media. I have guys, man, that follow me on Facebook that try to message me. And it's just, you know, I try to get back. I just don't have time. Like, when I say I'm busy, when I tell you, like, I'm busy, physically, I don't have the time. And that's good. I like keeping myself busy. I don't like having time to have idle time. I never have idle time. I try to get away from that because if you're idle, then you're not productive. This girl, she got a lot of idle time, man. And I'm telling you, and I'm telling you again, MMA Labs, they figured that stuff. Look, they like, look, McKenzie, they had a meeting about her too. Man, McKenzie going to get knocked out. And then she going to blame us, okay, for why she ain't getting the job done. I'm telling you, this girl ain't dedicated. She not dedicated to the MMA Lab way. We got to get out of here. That's what they did. They got up out of there. Watch what I tell you. McKenzie Dern is going to lose because it's going to be because of a lack of commitment. It's going to be a lack of discipline and a lack of commitment, and McKenzie Dern will lose. And she's going to get pieced up. She better be, you know, she better be careful. And she better be thinking about Amanda Bobby Cooper. She better be thinking because Amanda Bobby Cooper coming. And Amanda, you know, she's gotten better. Okay, her ground game has gotten better. McKenzie Dern got her work cut out. ABC is not going to be a walk in the park. She's not going to be able to grab ABC and just take ABC to the ground and do what she wants to. It's not going to happen. McKenzie Dern, she's going to have to work to get Amanda Bobby Cooper to the ground. See, this ain't BJJ. This ain't a BJJ tournament. And I keep telling people over and over and over that BJJ on the mat is different from BJJ inside of an octagon. It's totally different. Because, see, the cage, you can use all the octagon tricks to use it to your advantage to neutralize a BJJ expert. But a lot of people don't get that. Well, she was good at BJJ, but this is MMA. This ain't BJJ. McKenzie Dern gonna walk around, gonna mess around and walk right into an ass whooping. That's what she gonna do. See, guys, I understand psychology. I may can't pick the fights all the time correctly, but I understand psychology. I've been right. I was right about Ronda Rousey. I mean, I told y'all, and I get, you don't know what you're talking about. Me and Ronda ain't suicidal. But then Ronda talking about she thought about killing herself. I understand psychology. I understood Megan Anderson. I told y'all Megan Anderson will not get the smoke with Cyborg. I predicted it. I told y'all. But I had people, coach, you know, talking about Megan Anderson. Yes, she'll fight Cyborg. You just hate Megan. And then what happened? Megan Anderson ain't worked that work. Won't that work? Told y'all about Jermaine Durandamay. I tried to tell you. I said, look, Jermaine Durandamay did not want it. Jermaine was scared. What happened? Jermaine Durandamay didn't want that work. Told y'all about Holly Holm. I told y'all that Holly Holm was a warrior, that Mike Winklejohn was pulling the strings and running his mouth. Wasn't Holly. And I told y'all this. I told y'all that, you know what, if the fight don't happen, it's going to be because of Mike Winklejohn. Tried to tell y'all this. Told y'all. People still hating, coming on here saying all kind of crazy stuff. Look, I've been right about these psychological issues every single time. And this is no different. McKenzie Dern, she's going to get in there. She's going to get beat up. And I'm telling you, it's going to be because of a lack of discipline and a lack of commitment. All of those two, they're going to play together, and this is going to be one of the downfalls of McKenzie Dern. That's just how it is. That's just the way that is. That's just the way that is. So, I mean, hey, love her or hate her, you know? I mean, she's going to sell. People are going to pay to look at her. They're going to pay. They're going to watch Mackenzie Dern. But see, the one thing is, though, Mackenzie Dern, she's going to have to win. And that's just the way that is. And unfortunately, as you move up that strawweight ranking, the level of opponent get more aggressive and aggressive and aggressive. And that level of opponent, they're not taking no names. They ain't finna be coming in there and Mackenzie Dern. Nah, man, they're gonna try to knock her down a peg because they're sick of fighters like Mackenzie Dern who don't have to do half the work getting all the attention. They don't like that. You know how many people want to get her in that octagon right now? I guarantee you, people like Rose Namajunas and even Joanna Jacek, they're just thinking about how they could beat the piss out of Mackenzie Dern. They're thinking about it. I bet you Cynthia Cavillo wish she can get in there and choke out. Guys, it's so many of these strawweights, man, I'm telling you. There's so many of them that they can't wait to get their hands on Mackenzie Dern. They can't wait. It's no different, man. Amanda Bobby Cooper can't wait to get her hands on Mackenzie Dern. She gonna get her chance. And ABC, they trash talking. ABC got to come on and get this in because if she don't, then Mackenzie Dern will be validated and talking her trash. And that's just the way that is. Right now, I'm not a fan. I'm not a Mackenzie Dern fan, and I can't see that right now. I'm done. Subscribe to the best women's MMA platform on YouTube.